Episode 4, Mobilise. Move, you've got to move. Crush the workout. The whole idea is to prove to you and everyone else that you can do whatever that work is. The workout is more than the sweat. It's more than the muscles. It's more than the booty or the six-pack or the selfie in the bathroom. It's a physical and mental fitness, my friend. It ain't just one without the other. You're conditioning your body and your mind to accept that being more athletic, more stronger, will lead you to being a more resilient version of you. Don't feel like it's just the start. Feel like it's the first step, and soon enough you'll actually enjoy it. You'll be glad that you did, that you mobilized. The only bad workout that you do is the one that you miss. The crap that's in your head, soon it will be gone. The workout might be hard, but it's good for you. It's good for you up here, it's good for you physically, and it's good for you emotionally. Do not forget that. It's going to help ward off all those bad vibes. Think about it. When is the last time that you went into workout feeling crap and came out feeling worse? Unless that was the intent, to really push yourself beyond. But generally, most people I know, myself included, the workout is designed to make you feel better about yourself. Yeah, it might mean you get that odd top of worse, and then they say we're here to F you up. But that's code for we're here to challenge you so that you can look back and realize what you can do is more than you give yourself credit for. The endorphins, the natural high, all of that stuff, it's all natural simply from you doing that workout. You don't do it well, and then maybe you get all the ants, or what they call those automatic negative thoughts creeping in, but the workout will help you. When you don't do it, bad health, no energy, crap sleep, snoring, erratic heart rate, signs that you're on the path to something else, and that medical emergency will smack you in the face like a 2x4. And then you'll be sitting back wondering one day, when you can't tie your shoelaces or your kids are helping you go to the toilet, why you didn't just do what you said you were going to do in the first place. So yeah, I'm reading this because some of this stuff needs to be written down. All of the niceties, the comorbidities, we call them, diabetes, respiratory disease, heart attack, signs, crap immunity, poor cognitive ability, Alzheimer's, yep. They're all the stuff that you can look forward to when you just want to sit in your ass and do nothing. They're there waiting to simply go, pick me next. They're like taking the ticket when you go to the meat locker or the delicatessen and you're after your 500 grams of ham. They're sitting there waiting for you. So, it all starts with that mobilize. Get the work done. It might start with a 10-minute walk once a day, then twice, and then it maybe might progress into 10 squats, 10 sit-ups, 10 push-ups, whatever it is, every hour on the hour at your day at work. Something that is so little, but yet can work so much. A walk out of work. Something generally that is physical, and something that, as we say, is not a sweat-less solution. It'll raise your heart rate. It might peak, might cause a little bit of sweat. It might make you to think about why you did not do this so many times before. So episode 4, mobilize.